Hello and welcome to the Image Acquisition on Inspector83x video in the Signova series. In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up the camera to acquire high quality images in just a few steps. For a general introduction to the Signova user interface, I recommend to watch the Discover Signova in a few minutes product tour video before continuing. To follow this tutorial, get yourself an Inspector83x with the Signova sensor app and some samples. In my case, I use chocolate bars. But now, let's capture great images. My Inspector83x is mounted on an articulated arm parallel to the table with a distance of around 35 cm. As the illumination is very bright, don't look into it and best point it downwards. The device is powered up and connected to my PC using the USB-C service interface, as it's super easy, but Ethernet works fine as well. To access the user interface, open a web browser like Google Chrome and enter the default IP address of the USB connection 169.254.0.1. Switch to Configure for parameter adjustment and select Free Running to continuously acquire images. I placed two chocolates in the field of view, but with a different distance to the camera, to demonstrate effects of optical adjustment in the upcoming steps. My Inspector83x is equipped with a 12mm C-mount lens. The higher the millimeter value or focal length, the more you zoom in on your objects. The lens is equipped with a manual aperture and manual focus, which needs to be adjusted to each specific application. To get access, unscrew the protection hood. The lower ring on the lens is for the focus adjustment. Turn it to set the distance from the camera, called focus point, in which the object appears the sharpest. The upper ring is for the aperture adjustment. It controls a variable opening inside the lens, through which light passes onto the camera, just as the iris controls the pupil in the human eye. With aperture, you control how much light enters through the lens into the camera, resulting in a brighter or darker image, and how large your depth of field is, affecting the distance range around the focus point, in which the image also appears sharp. As brightness and depth of field effects counteract to each other, you need to choose them wisely for your specific application. On the lens, aperture numbers, or f-stops, are printed on, where small numbers represent much light but a shallow depth of field, and large numbers represent less light but a larger depth of field. To capture a well-exposed image, so not too bright or too dark, the time how long the image sensor inside the camera captures light needs to be set according to the chosen aperture. This is adjusted by the exposure time parameter, to which we'll come in a minute. In industrial machine vision applications, choose the aperture number just large enough that all relevant areas of your part appear sharp, but keep it as small as possible to avoid motion blur caused by high exposure times on moving objects. In my chocolate bar application, this the distance variation very little, so I can choose a small aperture number. In this case, I will go for 2. I then adjust the focus to get the chocolate appear as sharp as possible. But as the image is now way too bright to fine-tune the focus point, let's adjust the acquisition settings in the user interface first. These software parameters define how long the light is captured by the image sensor and how the image is created digitally. To do so, select Acquisition on the left and click Run Autosetup on the right to let the camera figure out the best image settings. You can either use the recommended configuration, select an adjusted contrast version, or change parameters such as exposure time, contrast or brightness by yourself. I am happy with the recommendation, as the image is well lit with a good contrast. Let's switch back to the focus optimization. As it is hard to see if the focus is set perfectly, I recommend to zoom in on the image by rotating the mouse wheel or using the scroll gesture on the touchpad. Now adjust the focus ring on the lens until the text appears as sharp as possible. To see the full image again, simply select the Reset View button in the bottom left corner. Now move the chocolate around and place other samples below the camera to verify that the image looks great for them as well. I now click on the Save Permanent button in the top right corner to save my configuration to the inspector, so it automatically captures well-exposed images after each boot up. With a great image set, it's now time to start inspecting our chocolate bar. So check the following tool videos to see how easy you can solve even challenging applications using Signova.